very successful business owner, and yeah, what's your sort of story?
Oh, mate, drive, hard work, coming from a poor background. We lived in a housing commission area, so for us just to have joggers was like a big deal.
Mm.
I guess all those little things, you know, going with your parents, shopping, watching them, not being able to afford to buy you things, I think really drove me, and I just wanted for my family to afford things. That was my first drive. If I got to live in Lebanon for 6 years, when I come to Australia, I got to see the poor side because we come with nothing. So I got to see how it is to live below the poverty line. But I also understood it from the Middle East, from Lebanon, which was again another living in poverty and in war. I put it down to, you know, just seeing how tough people did it, and I just wanted more for my family and for myself, I guess.
And how much do you think Raksha is worth in 2023?
Honestly, it's too hard of a question, mate. If you ask me what it's worth, I would say hundreds of millions, you know? And then if you're more realistic, I really don't know, mate. It's nothing I focus on. For me, it's not about what my wealth is. I guess this is a good lesson for people out there, I guess. It's never about how much you're worth, because your wealth or what your worth is, what is your lifestyle like now? You know, where are you mentally? Where are you financially today? Where are you family-wise? That's how you judge wealth. We don't...